investments. I bought my first property investment back in 1982, which was commercial. And for 35 years, I've been a property investor and developer and a investor in other things as well. I wrote what was the first major course about property investment back in 2002. And since then, I've become very interested in the whole issue about retirement, having enough income, how you deal with the pensions disaster, and so on. And that has evolved into an investment strategy called Fresh, which I'm going to explore today, which my entire company follows. But I am very focused in this particular presentation on one division of our company called the Plutus Portfolio. So a little bit of background about what underlies the Plutus Portfolio. Avantis Wealth is currently a team of 12. We are a specialist investment broker. We have an enormous amount of investment experience between the senior management team, and we are very focused on delivering profitable investments that primarily work according to the Fresh investment strategy. So what is the Plutus Portfolio? The first thing is, let me identify who it's for. It's for affluent investors, and I'll tell you what that means. They have to be high net worth, according to the government regulations, which means that you either have to be earning $100,000 a year or have £250,000 in your investment portfolio, not including your own property and not including your pension. Okay. Now, if you don't fulfill that criteria, then you may still be able to invest with us in our main division of Aventis Wealth, which is focused on investments between $10,000 and $100,000. But the Plutus Portfolio is focused on investments from a minimum of £100,000. Now, whilst that seem a very high barrier, what it's enabled us to do is go into the market and talk to a lot of our investment providers and say, hey guys, if we are bringing you clients who have a minimum of 100,000, let's talk about a completely new proposition. It's sadly, or positively, depending on how you look at it, a case of money makes money. So what I'm going to share with you today are things that are not available in the general marketplace. And we currently have 6 investments available in the Plutus Portfolio. And what I want to do is to evolve for you the methodology, how we choose investments, talk a little bit about 3 specific investments. So it's not just general information, it's very specific. Now, some of you may well have questions, and I hope you do. I'd be grateful if you hold them until the end, because as you know, these presentations are pretty short. And I argued with the organizers because I normally like to have about an hour and a half to take people through this, and I've got 40 minutes. So I'm going to give you a lot of information in a short space of time. For those of you who want it, I'm happy to make this presentation available to you. That'll be an option at the end of the presentation. And if I have time, I will take general questions from the audience at the end. Alternatively, after I finished, I will wait outside in the anteroom and I'll answer everybody's questions for as long as it takes. We also have a team of, I think there's 6 or 7 of us, just downstairs on our stand, if you don't manage to catch me or you think of something you want to ask later on. So I want to start off with the background and the issues that I see in the general marketplace. Now, I'm putting myself into the lion's den here because I'm going to start by talking about shares. And I know that a lot of you will be share traders or share investors. Now, if you're a short-term share trader and you've got a methodology that works for you and you're making money, fantastic, and you like the involvement, and I know that is true for many of you. If you are invested in shares because you're trying to build a long-term secure fund, whether it's for your pension or for your kids' school fees or whether it's because you want more income now, then you've had a more challenging time, particularly if you look at this over a significant period. So I want to just visit a couple of charts, and this is about as techie as I get. This is the FTSE 100 going back to the turn of the century, the beginning of 2000. And in that time, very roughly, the index has grown from 7,000 to 7,400 as a couple of days ago. And in fact, anything above 7,000 has only happened in the last few weeks. So we have faced a situation where, yes, you can point to the fact that since 2009, we more or less had a strong bull market. But if you have been a long-term share investor, can you really say over that period of time that any of the major funds have delivered any kind of a significant return? And the reality is in front of you, we've seen 4.33% growth, not per year, across 17 years. Now, I don't know about you, but considering that nothing is guaranteed, that you have huge volatility, huge uncertainty, it just seems to me that putting all your eggs in that basket might not be the best option. Now, interestingly, if you look at what other people are predicting, and these are much cleverer people than me, this is actually Trading Economics, and they reckon that by 2020, the FTSE 100 will be at around 5,500, i.e. 26% below where it is now. Now, how many of you would be very happy to lose a quarter of your portfolio value in the next 3 years? No hands, no surprise. So let's just say that it's challenging because you are relying on some future uncertain growth for your future financial security. And to me, that kind of doesn't add up. Now, those of you who've been investing and putting your money in cash ISAs or banks or building societies will know what's happened to your fixed interest securities. And here's the chart going all the way back for the last 10 years, gilt yields, and you can see what's happened. Now, most of you, if you have cash ISAs, I think it's something like £96 billion in cash ISAs are paying less than 1% a year. So again, if you have money saved up, it's all very well for it to be in a tax-free environment, but what are you actually earning out of it? So it's all very well to say it's low risk. It's all very well to say, oh, my capital's safe, but if for the rest of your life you can't afford to eat, that doesn't seem to me a very good deal either. So the two major asset classes, excluding property, that have basically been the foundation of the advice from the entire financial services sector is at the very least questionable. Now, many people said, I get this, I'm going to buy residential property. And let me say that my background in residential property and commercial property is huge, all the way back to 1982, and I still have a portfolio. But in the last 3 years, I have seen major changes in the market and about to come into the market, which call this a little bit more into question. First of all, property is volatile. The cycle might be longer than it is for other assets, but it's still there. Yield is a problem because yields have been falling as prices have been rising. Liquidity is a problem. If you want to sell, you may or may not be able to at the price you want, and it could easily take a number of months. Hands-on, particularly for older investors, is a problem. I've had enough of every single week my property managers calling me, my rental agents, this washing machine's broken, we've had a flood, this guy hasn't paid his rent, etc., etc. It is absolutely non-stop. And now we have the big tax question. How are you going to manage, those of you who are highly geared and who pay tax at 40%, have you calculated the impact of the withdrawal of this tax relief by the government over the years 2017 to 2020? For some people who are highly geared and paying tax at marginal rates of 40%, they are going to move their portfolio from a cash positive and profitable to cash negative and losing money. Now, when you look at all those things, you have to ask yourself is, if you're in the market for income, which many people are, is a property portfolio going to do that? So here is the real house prices. This is Nationwide's chart. And what's really interesting is if you divide this up into 10-year periods, and I've done that at the bottom here, you'll actually see that in two periods of 10 years, 85 to 95, and 2005 to 2015, overall, the market has shown a small loss. I'm not saying your individual property shows a loss, the market as a whole. In 75 to 85, it was a modest profit. In 95 to 2005, it was stunning. Huge profit. The problem is that a lot of property investors take generalizations like, oh, over the last 40 years, property's made 6% or 4% or whatever number they come up with, and think that means they're going to be okay. It doesn't. In 3 out of 4 of these 10-year periods, property would not have been a great investment from a capital growth perspective. And it certainly wouldn't be a capital growth from a rental perspective. This is a company called Live Yields that measures real yields being achieved right across the UK. And you'll see these numbers are typically, if I were to average, around 5% gross. Gross. That's before all the things I've put on the right-hand side. There are people in London who are at zero in terms of a real yield. There are people in the rest of the country who may be at between 2 and 4%. Now, again, there's exceptions, and I'm sure there's some very clever people in the audience who have bought below market value, added value by doing up a property, managed to buy very cheaply for whatever reason, and are now getting yields of 8, 10, 12, 14%, right? But in general, this is the score. So that's the background that I see in the investment market, and it's pretty sad because it means that the traditional ways we've looked at making money haven't worked as well as they should have done. In addition, we have greater worries because now we are providing for ourselves way beyond the age of 70. If you look at life expectancies, these are the life expectancy charts, already today, a man of 80, if you retire at 65 and you're a man, you're expected to live till you're 83. So typically, 18 to 20 years in retirement. 50 years ago, it was 5 years in retirement. In another few years, they're now talking about retirement age for people born today going to be 70 or more. And that still won't accommodate the increase in life expectancy. So you are having to prepare yourself for more and more years in retirement, which means, guess what, more and more money at a time when pensions, investments, all the traditional ways of making money are not working as well as they did. And on top of that, we have inflation. Now, at the moment, inflation is around 2.4%. It's been below 2% for quite a while. The long run is around 3%. And basically, inflation halves your money in 20 years. So, not only do you need to deal with having the money to last that long, you need to be able to cope with inflation. And if your investments are returning 2 or 3 or 4% before inflation, after inflation, they're simply not going to cut it. So that's the space that I come from. And obviously, I wouldn't want to stand here and say to you guys, okay, that's the end of the story, go away and cry in your soup. So I'm going to talk about a way which my clients use to actually do better. And the first thing is I want to talk about fresh. And I've drawn this risk-reward chart, and this is my own judgment, so you can play around with these balloons and decide you want to move them. Risk is up on this axis, reward is along the bottom. And I have put on it a new category of assets that I'm calling fresh. And we're going to talk about what those are and why they're there on the risk-reward chart. Now, those of you who are in equities and funds, again, if you're a share trader and you're very good at it, guess what? You won't be there. You can move your bubble as high as you want. The problem is you have to be on it pretty much every day. And if you don't have the time, you don't have the expertise, you don't have the intent to do that, relying on day-to-day or month-to-month or week-to-week share trading is somewhat problematic. So remember that what I'm looking for here is investment that you can have and not worry about. So what exactly is fresh? Well, each of these letters stands for something very important. So the F stands for fixed income. My clients want to know, before they invest, exactly what they're getting back. R stands for rewarding returns. What do I mean by that? I mean typically 7 to 15% a year, every year. So let's say you were offered an investment that gave you 12% a year return every year for the next 5 years. Absolutely without question. How many would think that 12% as a consistent return is worth having? Is that worth having? 12?
How safe is the investment?
Great question. How safe is the investment? I'll come on to that because we're going to deal with the S in a minute, which is exactly that. So in the Plutus portfolio, we actually have the option for you to do better than the 7 to 15% if you're willing to accept a slightly higher level of risk. And we'll talk about matching risk and reward. The E is an exit strategy, already defined. In other words, you commit to 3 years or 1 year or 5 years or whatever it is, and at the end of it, we know how your money is coming back to you and why it's coming back to you. That means we do not deal with any investments that mean that you own an asset like property. Why? Because property isn't liquid and we can't define the exit strategy. And if the market happens to take a dive 6 months before you want to exit, you could find yourself in a very tricky situation. So we have to know the exit strategy. Then S means we have to have security in place. Now this comes back to this gentleman's question about risk. If you buy shares, what risk are you taking? Are you taking any risk at all? Of course you are. Is there any security? No. Is there any guarantee? No. Is there any redress if the company goes bust? No. You're equity investors. You're the last people in the chain. Here's an interesting one. If you're invested in an ISA, a cash ISA, and you're getting 0.4%, do you have security? Yes, because if the ISA goes bust, the government will pay out at least up to a certain level. But what is the risk of you not meeting your financial goals? 100%. Risk isn't always about what you lose, it's about what you fail to gain. If for the rest of your life you can't eat every week, but you say proudly, I've got 200,000 in an ISA, I only earn 600 quid a year, and I can't eat, but by God, I'm protecting my capital, I think you've got your priorities wrong. So in general, and there are some exceptions in the Plutus portfolio, we have very strong security. And then the H is hands off, which means that you do not need to be involved in management. This is strictly invest it and wait and then get your return. So I'm going to talk you through now, briefly, through three of the six investments that are currently in the Plutus portfolio, and there's a seventh that's actually under discussion at the moment. So the first is this company that buys historic listed buildings in Germany and restores them. And some of you may have seen this investment. Very interestingly, this has been I hold this investment in my pension, and this has been the most requested investment ever since we started with this kind of investment some 5 years ago now. So this company now is around 8 years old. They employ 1,000 people. They have a credit rating that's unbelievable. And investors who invest have full first charge security over the investments which they work with. And the reason this works is twofold. They are able to buy with cash because they're using investor funds. So they are always at the front of the queue when it comes to negotiate a good price. They renovate the listed buildings, turn them into beautiful contemporary apartments, and most importantly, in Germany, the only tax break you can have if you are a wealthy German is to buy the finished apartments in these restored buildings. Because the German government, these are all in prime positions in the major cities like Berlin and Leipzig, the German government wants them to be brought back into everyday use. They've been trading for 9 years, and any clients who decide they like to look at this investment will get a complimentary all expenses paid trip to Germany to actually go and take a look for themselves. And I promise you, I can't think in 5 years that we've had one client who's come back and not been anything other than extremely impressed. So that is one of the investments. Key facts, the return on this investment is 10%. If you roll up your interest for 5 years, you get a 10% bonus. So you will get a 60% return over 5 years. Okay? and it's secured on first legal charge. So the point to make about this is that this isn't the highest return that we can offer, but this company is the biggest, most secure, has the most trading history, and therefore we and very strong security, and therefore we're very comfortable that this is as low on the risk scale as you could get. And in return, a 10% or 12% if you roll up your interest, we think is excellent. Okay, so I'm now slightly going up the scale to talk about this investment. By the way, some of you may wonder, why, Rod, why are you talking about investment two or talking about this investment? Why am I not naming it? Well, the simple answer to that is, in the Plutus portfolio, we because of the regulatory environment, we can only talk to investors who are high net worth and who have a minimum of £100,000 to invest. So we have an inquiry form, and if the first thing it has on there is a self-certification. And once you've done that, then I can talk freely and we can give you lots and lots of information about everything. Until that point, I'm restricted in what I can actually say to you, okay? And we're very careful to make sure that we observe all the regulatory requirements. So this investment is called debt trading with arbitrage and insurance. So coming straight to this gentleman's point about risk, this is a very, very interesting investment because, first of all, some of you may not know what I mean by debt trading. So on the left, you have a whole list of different kinds of debts that are issued by major organizations, including government bonds. In the UK, they would be called gilts. When they get into the market, they go through traders. They don't just go, somebody has to buy them, but they buy them through a trader. That trader, and how it works is, over on this side, you can see debts might be bought and held to maturity, they might be traded either when they're first issued or later on, or they may be available for sale, which means you're not holding them to maturity, but they haven't been traded yet. So we're in the middle section, people buying and selling debt securities, buying and selling government gilts, certificates of deposit and other things. The beauty about this is it's done via arbitrage. Arbitrage means that you can't buy the debt until you have yourself, until you have a buyer. So you match the buyer and the seller, and only at the point that both are committed do you make the trade. Now that's really important because it means you can't lose money on a trade. If you've tied up the buyer legally and you've tied up the seller legally, you facilitate the trade and you take a commission. Right, we don't do this. This is major traders, often from banks. Okay. The second point, so this is how you manage risk. Right, if they were to buy a whole load of debt and didn't have somebody to sell it on, they'd be holding stock. If they priced it wrong or they couldn't find the buyers, they'd be stuck. And we're talking millions or tens of millions or hundreds of millions. So that's why it's arbitrage. The second way they reduce risk is they have a AAA insurance underwritten by Lloyd's of London that covers all the possible risks that you could imagine, including things like hacking, cybercrime, directors stealing money, so that investors have got a raft of risks covered they probably didn't even realize existed. So what we have is the capital's underwritten at the 95%, so you have a risk of 5% of your capital. But now let's look at what you get. Well, if you have 100,000 minimum, you can choose 1, 2, or 3 year investment and either receive 10%, 12%, or 14%. So you can choose what works for you. Who thinks this is reasonable? 2 year investment, 12% on a low risk proposition? Okay. If you've got 250,000, then you can be paid. It's only a 12-month investment, and you can earn 2% a month, 24% a year. And if you want to roll it up and not be paid it quarterly, you'll be paid 26.82% for a 12-month investment. Who thinks that's good? Very good. So here's the problem I have. Most of you sitting there thinking, too good to be true, I don't believe it. These numbers are ridiculous. And what I can say to you is this. First of all, I believe that most people in this country have been brainwashed by the financial services sector to believe that it's okay to have 1 or 2 or 3%, that that's the norm. And the truth of the matter is that if you really understand the markets and you really start to learn about what's possible, you will realize that these returns are absolutely possible to deliver. And at, I would say, at less risk than holding a share. Okay? But the point is, I'm not expecting you to believe me because I'm standing here. What I'm expecting you to say is, if this were true, would I be interested? That's what you owe it to yourself, to at least ask that question. And what do I need to know to make sure I'm comfortable? And then we'll have a discussion and we'll provide information, and you either will be or you won't be. Okay? I'm an accountant, I'm not a sales guy. Well, I don't want to sell you anything. Our approach is completely different. That gentleman's smiling. Our approach genuinely is very different. We love the idea of having a portfolio of investments because it gives our clients choices. It means they can decide for themselves what they actually like. Now, the third investment I want to cover is FX trading. Now, I've had at least three conversations this morning when clients have said to me, I'm not interested, it's too risky. Anybody hold that opinion about FX trading? Okay, well, I'm going to put both hands in the air because I think normally FX trading is way too high risk for me, way too high risk for my clients. So why would we have this in our product line? And I'm going to explain to you how it works and why it's considerably different from traditional FX trading. So the first thing is, for those of you who don't know what's going on in the foreign exchange world, roughly $5 trillion a day flows through the markets. What that means is they're pretty transparent. The bigger the market, the less people can manipulate it. And that's very, very important because you don't want to be in a market that people really can mess around with. So how does this work? Well, the first thing is the return is 3% a month, 36% a year. And if you invest $1 million, there's a bonus. And if you invest $5 million, there's an even bigger bonus. The trading generates the profits. It's 100,000 minimum, as it is for all Plutus. You can withdraw your funds after the first 90 days at 35 days' notice. So you are not locked in long term. That's just basically a month, 5 weeks' notice. You can withdraw all your funds. You can, if you don't want to take the 3%, you can leave it to roll up. In which case, for those of you who haven't done the numbers, it comes to 42.6% a year for the first year, and you would double your money over 2 years. So we're in a whole nother league of return here. So, and this is through a regulated and audited Swiss company, and the regulation for FX trading in Switzerland, the company has just moved to Switzerland and bought a Swiss company, is stronger than it is in London. So the question is what makes it different to just handing your money to a trader? And this is what I want to, this is all technical stuff about how they actually work for those of you who might know about FX trading. But the important point is this. Your money doesn't go to the traders. Your money goes to the company as a loan with a fixed return of 3% a month. Okay? So you have a legally binding agreement that you're entitled to 3% a month. The money that goes into the company then goes to the traders. So the first thing is, if those of you who know that trading is done under leverage will know that you can not only lose your capital, you can lose a shirt. With this process, there is no possibility under any circumstances that you could lose more than your capital. You're not actually going to lose that, but there's no way because you're now insulated from the trading. The second thing is the company that has done this has been trading long enough and profitably enough to have something like currently £6 million of their own profits sitting in the company with which they will absorb any short-term variations. So they can't come to your capital and take and use it. They have to use their own profit to cover any short-term losses. And they're willing to do that because, quite simply, they make a lot more than 3% a month and they keep all the rest. So I love it that they have a profitable model. I don't care how much extra they make. What I care about is my clients get their 3% month after month after month. So, two ways then that risk is managed. First of all, you have a legally binding contract that pays you a fixed return that is insulated from the trading. And secondly, the profitability of the business already underpins the returns that you receive. Okay? So, you can invest in pounds, dollars, euros, or Swiss francs, and the capital is held, in fact, it's moving from the UK bank to a foreign bank because they've just bought this Swiss company. And you can access your capital within 35 days. So listen, here, I'm not trying to give you the whole story. I'm trying to give you a flavor and an introduction to the kind of returns that are genuinely possible. We spoke about 10% German property restoration. We talked about anywhere from 10 to 24% with debt trading, and I've talked about 36 to 44% with FX trading. But all of them designed to protect your money. That doesn't mean there's no risk. It means the risk is minimized, and you can decide for yourself. You have to look at two factors: level of risk, level of reward. My goal always is to minimize the risk and maximize the reward. And if I can keep doing that, and I can deliver that to you, then you will love us forever. And that's what I want, okay? So, to summarize this, it's a fixed loan agreement, 3% monthly payment, bonus if you pay more, withdraw at 35 days notice. It's run by some London City lawyers with a huge reputation. If this went wrong, they would lose their practicing certificates. They would lose their livelihood. They have an awful lot to lose if it didn't work as it should. There are lots of reasons, for those of you who are technical, why the trading strategies which they use are not available to private traders. And actually, that's a really important part of the conversation, because many people, individuals, try FX trading. Most people that I know who've tried it have lost money and given up in disgust, okay? There are some very sound reasons why that would be so, and they range from the speed of access of your computers to the spread that private investors have, which is completely separate when you're trading as an institution, and so on. So there are some very technical reasons why all the dice are loaded against individuals making money in FX trading. So, come back to the portfolio as a whole. Only available to high net worth investors with 100,000 income or £250,000 worth of assets. Minimum investments are 100,000. You need to consider your capacity for loss. And this is, of course, not an advice or a recommendation to invest. What I'd like to just briefly now finish off with is to say, okay, what about next steps? Well, we've given you an inquiry form. If you'd like to talk to us, we need you to complete this because you have to self-certify on here and sign the form, or else I can't talk to you and none of my team can about any of these investments. So please fill out this registration form. Also, you heard me talk about the fresh investment strategy. This is a very detailed 60-page report all about investment, all about the fresh investment strategy, and we'd love to send you a complimentary copy. All you have to do is tick the box on here that you'd like to have it, and we'll send you one. Also, if you complete the form, we will be able to send you, indeed give you, if you want to take it away, the Plutus portfolio brochure, this one, which has got a lot of detail about all six investments, okay? And I think that's probably it. So I've crammed an awful lot in. And of course, if you want the copy of this, you can have that as well. Again, you need to fill out the form, hand it in to one of my team on the way out. If anybody's got any questions, I'll take a couple of questions because I finished a few minutes early, and then afterwards we'll go out in the foyer. Please. Oh, you need the microphone.
You mentioned your portfolio, but what are your charges? I mean, you didn't talk about charges.
No, great question. So throughout our entire company, we have a very simple policy. We have no trail commissions. We charge our clients 2% plus VAT when they make an investment, for however long it is. So if it lasts 5 years, that's it. So it's one off. You also have to balance it, of course, against what you're getting back. If you pay 2%, you're getting 26% a year, you're probably very happy. If you're paying 1%, you're getting 1% a year, you're not at all happy. So that's how we work. Please, the gentleman at the back. Hang on, wait for the mic if you don't mind.
Are you FSA regulated?
Okay, question is, are we FCA regulated? And the answer is no, we're not, because these investments are not regulated. Okay? But let me say this. If you think that that's bad because you think that FCA regulation means your investments are safe, then you and I need to have a discussion, because that's absolutely not the truth. You could go and buy the riskiest mining shares in the world through a professional advisor, and they could go bust tomorrow and there will be no redress at all. So don't think that, you know, it's low risk. The government has decided in its wisdom that these investments aren't regulated, just like property isn't regulated. My view is that's because they're not so worried about them. If they were, they'd regulate them. Please, a gentleman here. And this is the last one I'll take. Have we got the mic, please? Oh, you. It's just coming.
How long have you been... Well, I've got three questions, really, but just in a word. How long have you been investing or putting investors' money into the FX trading? How much money has been invested in total, and have there been any losses?
There is currently around 27 million in that fund.
By you?
No, not via a few people.
Through you, how much?
Through us, 2 million in 8 weeks. We've only taken this on 8 weeks ago. The Plutus portfolio is new. Some of these clients, some of these investments, like the German one, we've been dealing with for 5 years. This is not. I have looked at many FX training deals and turned them all down until now. So, because they have been direct investment with the traders, there's been no protection for investors. You could lose your shirt. I haven't believed in their results. They've been too uncertain. I've seen the results. There have been no losses, in the sense of there hasn't been a month where they have lost money. There have been months where they've made less and months where they've made more. No, the track record of the company is 2 years. They've been doing this for 2 years. Our track record is 8 weeks. Okay? Otherwise, you could say you can never do anything new because, I mean, we like companies that have been doing it long enough for us to be comfortable they know what they're doing.
Thank you.
Okay. Okay, guys. So, thank you very much. The gentleman at the back, if you don't mind, I'll take your question just outside. I'll be just out here. And thank you so much for coming. And I hope to speak to you again and meet you all individually. So thank you so much.